name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Many a time we've mentioned that our church and its dogmas are built upon two very important understandings, and that is on Holy Scripture and Holy Tradition. And in the celebration of the baptism of our Lord, we see how important Holy Tradition is. Because Christ himself came to fulfill Holy Scripture, as he told St. John, the baptism forerunner, as we're being baptized. But also we know in the Gospel readings, especially from St. Luke, where he goes into more detail about this baptism, when he speaks about people that came to St. John for edification, for guidance. And as we all do, as we come to the church, we come to Christ and ask him for his guidance. And so the people came to St. John, and this gives us the beginning of what we call elders, spiritual fathers of the church that can guide us because they are full of the Holy Spirit. They are full of the grace of God through living an ascetic life. Because St. John, the prophet, forerunner, and baptist, showed us the foundation of ascetic life by living a life in the desert, by living a life of fullness of self-denial. So we see that Holy Tradition is an important part of our Orthodox life. And we see that people came to St. John, and as the people asked, what shall we do? Because the kingdom of heaven is at hand. And he said to them, he that hath two coats, let him impart to him that hath one. And the publicans also came. And of course we know that they are what is called in the modern terms, the tax collectors. And they asked, what shall we do? And he said to them, exact no more than that which is appointed you. And the soldiers came also and asked, what shall we do? And he said to them, do no violence to no man, neither accuse any falsely, and be content with your wages. We also know that in St. Mark's Gospel, he talks about Jesus came into Galilee preaching the gospel of the kingdom of God. And he says to each and every one of us, repent and believe the gospel. Oh, how good it would be if we had childlike faith, a pure heart, and a clean soul, because this is how we can believe the gospel. And we must believe every word of the gospel because we know it is the Holy Scripture. It is given to us through God himself. And yet many of us have doubt. Many of us cannot explain a lot of the things in the gospel to ourselves. And thus a lot of people have fallen away from the faith because they don't understand the gospel. They are upset about the differences in the gospel. When Joseph, as an example, is called the husband of Mary, people don't understand that he was like a guardian. He wasn't a husband in an understanding that we do in our modern terms. And these are many things that are in the gospel that people have trouble expecting and understanding, and yet we know with childlike simplicity, with pureness of heart, children take everything at face value and they believe it wholeheartedly. And this is what Christ is asking of us, to wholeheartedly believe the gospel. Believe in Christ, that he is the Savior of the world. He is the second essence of the Trinity that came to save man from himself. Because he created us perfect. He created us to be God of light. And yet we allow sin to crawl into our hearts, crawl into our lives, crawl into our souls. And as it says in the prayer that we just had in the blessing of water, the decay of sin ruins man and mankind. And against this, we must always fight. And we know that we have different callings, as it says in today's epistle reading. Some are apostles, some are evangelists, some are preachers, some are teachers, and most of us are ordinary people. But God has said to us, repent and believe the gospel. And one thing we are all capable of doing is asking forgiveness and saying we're sorry, because we can all repent. And we know that repentance is the entrance into the kingdom of heaven. And this we can do if we put away our pride, put away our self-love, put away our ego, and live for Christ and accept the gospel and its truth wholeheartedly in our souls, our heart, and in our life, and living by the gospel, then we can bring repentance and we can bring God's Spirit and grace upon our lives, upon our souls and our hearts. can all do. And this is what God's message is to each and every one of us. Repent and believe the gospel.